Hey everybody, it's Kane, and today we are checking out River TV live on demand on the Fire TV. Now, I believe River is on quite a few devices, so you could just search it on your smart TV. You could probably watch it on the internet, on your phone. This day and age, a lot of these apps are out there like Prime Video, Disney, etc. The difference with River, it's live TV on demand, and it's actually really cool. So we're going to go into guest mode today. So basically, if you're trying to look for it, the best way with the Fire TV, as long as you can talk and it works and it plays right with you, is you hit the top microphone button, you hold it down, and you say the following: River TV app. And there you go. So it actually brought up River TV app, and we just hit the center button on our little up and down arrow. Well, it doesn't have the arrow, it's a circle, right? But in the center of the circle, you click that, and then you got your River TV. So we hit it again, and we bring it up. Now, I've already opened this up. I'm in guest mode. So basically, if you like it, they have a registration. You can go through it, and everything's there. So River TV offers you tons of TV shows, channels. They have movies. Basically, this is your live TV for a pretty good deal. It's I think it's $16.99 a month. So depending on your budget, it might be worth it, might not be worth it, but it's not a bad deal, honestly. And basically, you can go to the guide here and you can get kind of an idea of what they offer here. So you got Global, you know, CH, Showcase, Revolt, Adult Swim, History, History 2, National Geographic. I don't even know. I can't read that. I'm blind. Too small for me. But they have a show on Building Giants. Oh, okay. That's cool. Combat Ships. Oh, cool. It sounds like it's kind of like a military channel or something like that almost. But anyways, you got Women's Network, Slice, Lifetime, Cottage Life, you know, Makeful, T plus E, Journey, Law Crime, Cheddar, Newsy, Newsmax TV, Euronews, i24 News, YTV, Teletoon, Treehouse, Family Junior. I don't even know what that is. Is that Chargo something? Oh, Charge, I think. I guess they all use like these short. They confuse me. They got Supergirl on right now. You know, and if I had the account, I could get it now. Yeah, $16.99. You can get it for 7 days free, and we'd be able to watch it right away. You got Crime Investigation. You got Movie Time. You got Silver Screen Classics. You got Rewind, and basically it goes on and on. I'm not going to go reading through this. There's some foreign channels as well. Basically, they got the movie channels in here, and it just goes on, and it's pretty cool, honestly. And that's for $16.99. I think basic cable is, what, $40? So that is River TV, and they also have on-demand stuff here as well, which is pretty cool. So you can say, oh, I want to see what Showcase shows are on demand. And look at this. If you want to watch G.I. Joe right now, apparently a bunch of G.I. Joes, you could watch it right now on demand. You just click that and boom, it would come up. Obviously, I don't have River TV right now, so it's going to yell at me. And that is River TV for you, though. And that's pretty cool. It's a very nice app because it's quite sleek. It's all built into it. And that's the one reason why I like it a lot, is because it's simple. You open River TV app and it has a guide built right into it. And I love it. Now, another one I recommend is Stack. Now, Stack, unfortunately, Stack TV does not make it as simple to begin with. So Stack TV is actually part of Prime Video. And Prime Video is Amazon, so it's getting already a little confusing. Now, as far as I know, for Prime Video, you need to have an Amazon account. And as far as I know, you need an Amazon subscription. Now, a subscription is pretty cheap. And anyone with Prime, basically Amazon Prime, if you know what that is, because you get lots of shipping from Amazon, you pay, I think, like $79.99 a year or something like that, you probably already have what they call Amazon Prime. Well, you actually get Prime Video for free. So you can open up Prime Video and check it out anytime, and boom, you're golden. Now I'm going to get out of here because I'm actually in one of their channels, but this is Prime at the, you know, here's Prime, you know, you can go home, and these are all the different, you know, shows on Prime. You know, they got lots of programs and shows on here. Hey, look at, they even have 24 there. There you go. That's the real good 24, not that new one that they tried putting out. But anyways, you know, Prime Video is great. And then if you go to the very top, so don't pay attention. If I'm going too fast, listen, you know, you can rewind. I'm just going all the way to the top till I can't go up anymore. We go over to the store. This is where you can buy, you know, a video. So it's like, oh, I want to watch the new whatever. You can buy shows and movies on here. rent them, etc. Even new releases down here. But what we're going to go is to channels over here. And somewhere in here, if you don't own Stack TV, it should show up, and then you should be able to purchase Stack TV. Now, we do own Stack TV because I actually got it during the barbecue to show people, you know, what you know is built in. And this one was simple because you just clicked a button, boom, I was done, which I really liked. And my spouse loves it too. She watches all these different shows on it, and it's got lots of the on demand, sort of like River TV. Honestly, it's actually a bit cheaper. I believe it's $12.99 for Stack TV. Now, you do get less live channels, though. I have to admit, you do get less overall. So it's up to you if it has everything you need or not, but basically it has all the on-demand content as well. But what's kind of nice is if you go to the very beginning, so we hit the home button all the way back to your original Fire TV here, you can go to live. Now, this is a little confusing. Don't ask me why they did this, but if you scroll all the way to the bottom of live and click channel guide, you can actually open what you basically have subscribed to the Fire TV or the Amazon, which I only have Stack, so it shows up the listing here. Now, as far as I know, if you get River TV, it doesn't show on here, but River TV has a really good app anyway, so it's not a big deal. But basically, this is where your TV guide is if you want to watch live TV shows through here. So you got History, National Geographic, Showcase, Slice, Treehouse, Teletoon, Women's Network, YTV, Action. I don't know what Action is. Is that like, yeah, I don't know actually. Huh. Anyways, you got Food Network, Global Maritimes, basically every global out there, which is good because they're the different time zones, right? So if there's a program you were going to miss, you can watch it at a different time zone, basically on one of the other versions, which is kind of pretty cool on that sense. So a very short list amount of shows that you can watch on live, but a lot of them people enjoy. Like I know people would sit on Women's Network all day long and watch it, or Food Network, or where's the other one we were looking at, or HGTV. Actually, I like HGTV when I'm at the hotel. I don't watch it at home. I stay away from live television, period. I'll only watch on demand. But you know, and you got National Geographic, you got the Showcase. So it basically has a lot of great programs on here. And you have to remember, the Stack one was like, I believe, $12.99. The other one, River TV, I think was $16.99. And so when you think about that, those are quite cheap, and you definitely don't need both of them because they pretty much have you know, the same content. I find River TV has a bit more, but also when you're looking at the price of them and you think about, well, how much do I pay for cable TV? Well, from what I hear from most people, basic cable TV is about $40 a month. So this is a pretty good deal if you ask me. I think it's a really nice. But anyways, it's up to you guys. I just wanted to show you that. Obviously, if you go to live, you can also find other apps. They do have list a bunch of apps here as well. So you got CBC Gem. And so that's all the CBC and all the content for that. And, you know, it's as simple as just clicking and opening it. Like, even if I don't have it right here, at least on the Fire TV, all I have to do is click OK. And it'll queue it, it'll start downloading it, and it'll run it. And then I can open it up and I can check it out. And that's the beauty and simple part of Fire TV. And that's why actually we suggested people to get a Fire Stick. And I know some people couldn't get it, you know, through, you know, what we had here at MBW. I had to remember what we are. you can get one on Amazon. They're quite cheap. They're about $40-$50. When they go on sale, they can go as low as $29, basically $30. So that's pretty nice too. A lot of this stuff also is on smart TVs, Android boxes, etc., etc. So it's worth checking out. And I'm going to do more videos and guides as well over time. If you guys have suggestions, like you have trouble issues, or, you know, maybe you have a problem with, you know, your computer on the internet, like you do a certain task, you're wondering, you know, how do you do this? How do you protect yourself from that? Whatnot? You just ask the questions, and I'll make videos over time and I'll post them and I'll share them with you. So this is CBC Gem, for example. So, you know, I just wanted to show you how simple that was. So, here it is. I don't really like the look of there. This looks so weird the way they have things going on here, obviously. But there you go. So let's go over here. I didn't pay for a cent on this. I don't know. I think some stuff you have to pay, some you don't. So, like, for example, you have to sign in for some of this stuff. But apparently the National here, I don't need to sign up for this. So here's the National. This might, it says live here. So there you go.
Essentially, all of the votes have already been tallied in Michigan.
There you go. So apparently Biden's winning right now, or unless that's for one district area, but there you go. I hate those earbud things. I know everyone loves them, but it's like everyone wears them. They look so silly. But look at this. You got Family Feud. There you go. Can you actually watch that? Family Feud. The trailer. So I've never, you know, obviously I'm clicking this first time ever. You saw I didn't have it. Here you go. I am apparently watching. Oh, they have commercials. Life doesn't always go according to plan. This was planned. This was unplanned. Okay, so financial plan adapt to there's a pause button, right? Yeah. Can I fast forward? Oh yeah, you can. Find out your score. Ah. Chung family. We're not interested in your commercials. There you go.
The families have all been socially bubbled, and we have been socially distanced.
Okay, so there you go. Family Feud, or whatever the hell it's called. Social distancing edition. But there you go. You get the idea. So I know some things on here are paid, but I think they offer some that aren't paid, and it's worth checking out. It's CBC Gems. So, you know, there you go. That's just one, you know, network, obviously, in their shows. But it goes on. You know, you got CNN, Global, A&E. It goes on and on and on. So this is the beauty with the Fire TV anyways. I find it quite simple. I got one for my spouse, actually, ages ago. It was for last Christmas, and I bought it for the kitchen because she likes to put around in the kitchen. Obviously, we got a little TV on the top of the fridge. I had an Android box I had on there. I paid a pretty penny on it, actually probably more than what I paid for the Fire Stick. And she had nothing but issues. She spent more time fighting with it than she got to ever watch stuff in there. Now all she has to do is pick up a controller and boom, just click what she was watching, resume. It's pretty handy. So anyways, yeah, I really love the Fire TV, and I do recommend it. If you don't own it, check out Amazon. You just have to literally search on Amazon Fire TV. The best part about it, if you order your own Fire TV, you guys are going to like this. If you order the Fire TV directly off of Amazon, they basically like pre-customize it for you. So I guess I have the Amazon app on my phone, and I had another Amazon device. I don't know how it all works, but basically when I plugged it in, like, boom, brand new, spanking new, set it up, configured it, everything. Pretty much what it did was it knew my Wi-Fi information because it was on there already. And so it did the Wi-Fi, it logged me in, it was up and running. I didn't have to sit there typing in my user and password and all these codes or anything, because basically at the right side, before you click, you know, add to cart, it'll have options and it'll actually send you a personalized version of the stick. And then that way you just basically plug and play, and it does everything for you. Now, obviously, it might not do the Wi-Fi information, just because I think you have to have another Fire TV app, I believe, to have that done, or at least download the the Amazon app on your phone. But I do know that it's a lot easier to set it up than most devices out there. But like I said, most of this stuff is on pretty much any smart TV, Android, heck, your phone, your computers, your browsers. It doesn't matter. Most of the stuff is out there everywhere. But yeah, either way, I'm gonna make more videos over time. You guys tell me what you'd like to see. I just want to show people options, what there is out there. If you have questions, if you want to know if there's a certain app out there or how to do this and that, let me know, and I'll do my best to explain them. And if I feel like it, I will even make a video on it, you know, and explain it so other people know as well. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful day. Goodbye.